Welcome to part two of the PBIS Power Series. This part will focus on school-wide expectations. Before we jump into school-wide expectations, let's revisit our three-tier model of intervention. On the screen is the infamous pyramid I'm sure we've all seen. The green section of this pyramid means that about 80% of our students should respond to a Tier 1 intervention. Tier 1 interventions include the development of school-wide expectations, reinforcement systems, and use of data. Some students won't respond to Tier 1 and will need a more intensive intervention. We refer to that as Tier 2. And a small percentage of students, about 3 to 5%, will require more specialized intervention. That would be Tier 3. School-wide expectations should be created and taught to all faculty, staff, and students. The expectations usually take the form of 3 to 5 specific, positively stated behaviors that are agreed upon by all faculty. Lots of schools will use an acronym such as the 3 B's, be safe, be responsible, and be respectful, to help students and staff remember what their specific behaviors are. These behaviors are then defined more clearly in different locations of the school. Schools might use the classroom and define what being safe, being responsible, and being respectful looks like in the classroom. When a school has 900 students, we cannot assume that every student in that school knows what being responsible means. They may have a different idea of responsibility, so we have to teach them exactly what we want them to do in order to be responsible at the school. These 3 to 5 behavioral expectations then become common language across the school. When I see students in the hallway, if they are not practicing being responsible or respectful, I can say, "Hey, show me your 3 B's. Everyone in the school should know what I mean when I say the 3 B's. This is a way to discourage inappropriate behaviors and a way to encourage appropriate expected behaviors. Schools should already have their acronym and expected behaviors. This was established when PBIS was first introduced in Kyrene. As we discussed, some staff come to a school without knowing what their expectations are. Some students are new to schools and have never been taught those expectations. That's why these expectations and that acronym should become an automatic business as usual at the school. On occasion, we will need to reteach these expectations so that students and staff have a reminder of what they are. This slide shows the expectation matrix that was developed at Paloma. Paloma uses the 3 B's of be respectful, be responsible, and be safe. If you look closer at this slide, you can see that the 3 B's have been defined in the classroom, hallway, cafeteria, restroom, community, and playground. If you look within each square on the matrix, you'll see that respectful, responsible, and safe are further defined within the classroom, hallway, and other locations. The definitions of each one of the expected behaviors are stated in a positive way and are behavioral in the sense that they can be observed or measured. We cannot assume that students know exactly what our expectations of them are. For that reason, even when we say be respectful, be responsible, and be safe, we should still teach these behaviors directly to the students. The next few slides will give some strategies on how to best teach the expectations to your school. When teaching these behaviors to your school, a lot of the schools will develop school-wide lesson plans. These are plans for students to role play or demonstrate in their classroom what the behaviors are and how to behave in that way. Children learn best by example, and they learn best by practicing. Having them role play out the behaviors is a best practice. Many schools will choose to do a school-wide passport day. A passport is developed where each classroom goes to every different location in a school, and the students have the opportunity to role play the behaviors in those locations. After they've finished, they get a stamp or a sticker on their passport for having completed that location. One of the more creative ways to teach these expectations is to create videos. Lots of time in videos, the staff will lead the video and will show examples of what they should be doing and what they should not be doing. It's important for students to also know what they should not do and what is not expected of them. Videos are great ways to provide these examples. We talked about how behavior expectations, or your school's acronym, should become common language around the school. Another way to help promote the common language is to create signs that are posted throughout the school with the expectations on them. On this slide, you see a sign that has playground expectations that correspond to being safe, being responsible, and being respectful on the playground. Similar signs should be created and placed in the hallways, the cafeteria, classrooms, restrooms, or other areas that have been identified by the school. These signs should not be put on 8.5 by 11 paper necessarily, but should be big enough and creative enough that they draw attention to themselves when people are walking down halls or in the classrooms. Remember, these expectations should become common language around your school. Find creative ways to advertise this common language and make sure all staff are using it. Thank you for playing part 2 of the PBIS Power Series on school-wide expectations. If you have any questions about developing expectations or revisiting your school's expectations and how to teach them to staff and students, please ask your school psychologist or your BIT. Up next in our Power Series will be a discussion on school-wide recognition.